The pro teams that we've talked to, this is always like one of the most exciting things.
Does Dendy have a chance versus your AI?
We're gonna see a total revolution in esports training using AI and leveraging AI and technology.
Vasola is grenading the spawn, 3 dead for Optic Gaming.
You're able to find those diamonds in the rough, those kids who have the raw skill.
This is something Nico is just so good at doing.
So you're almost now moneyballing esports. We're going to see a total revolution in esports training by, you know, using AI and leveraging AI and technology to improve professional gamers in a way that traditional sports hasn't even seen yet. Sadly, gamers now mostly train by just playing the game of choice many, many hours a day over and over and over again, which really leads to the kind of player burnout that we see, especially in shooter games and MOBA games. You know, boxers, when they have an important match coming up, what they do is they find someone that's of a similar height, weight, reach of their opponent to come into their camp and to mimic their opponent and fight like them in that style so that they can practice and build that muscle memory in those contexts. Something like that doesn't really exist in esports at the moment, but it should be much easier to do than traditional sports because it's a digital medium. One of the things we're trying to do is build up these AI kind of bots. They can mimic humans better and mimic kind of the quirks of a particular person's performance so that you can train for those people and in those specific environments. I think that we'll kind of constantly see this sword sharpening where like the AI makes the human performance better, which will then make the AI performance better and kind of go back and forth. And in the end, we'll get what we want, which is better performing humans.
All three players on the CLG side going positive, so CLG owning the slaying category.
We need these kind of insights. The problem is a lot of the data that already exists in the game, these are team-based games. There's no actual metric of individual performance. The individual performance is tainted by the skill level of the people you're playing with and the people you're playing against. We need to be able to level that playing field and look at just you individually. What are your kind of unique skills and what you bring to the table and things like that. Building our own game basically is a much different endeavor. You can think of it like a personal coach AI that as you're playing the game is learning about your play style, it's learning about your mechanics, it's learning about your biases. We're taking all these things that we do in the lab and we're integrating them into a gaming environment seamlessly. And then just like a good coach in the gym, the AI is taking this information and it's tweaking the environment in the game at all times to constantly be at your personal most difficult kind of threshold to get some really unique data and insights about you specifically as a player. We need these kind of insights both for recruiting but also for training and for making people better. I think it has to. I think this has to kind of become the standard way that you train. What you'll see is kind of like almost a training arms race. The pro teams that we've talked to, this is always like one of the most exciting things, using AI and leveraging AI and technology. Each team's looking for that little cutting edge, and they all want that competitive advantage, right? Like, can we have it, but not other people? Esports is definitely leading the way in using AI for training because we have the advantage of it being a digital space and it being a digital world. With a lot of these traditional kind of sports entities getting into esports, you see especially a lot of NBA teams, you know, getting involved, buying and snatching up pro gaming teams, they're bringing a lot of knowledge with them from traditional sports. So you're starting to see, you know, them really caring about sleep, diet, they're bringing in nutritionists. Right now we're taking things from traditional sports and kind of trying to blend them into our world, but that will go vice versa as well, that we'll be able to take a lot of learnings and things that we can control easily in a digital world and also apply them to traditional sports. Traditional sports in the next 5-10 years are going to learn a lot from us.